Hello everyone, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to learn the next divisibility test. As you know that in earlier lecture we have started the concept of divisibility test, and in the previous lecture we have seen the divisibility test of 2, 5 and 10. Okay, so today in today's lecture we will see divisibility test of 3, 9, 4, 8 and 6. Fine, so see here. So see here, divisibility test, this is fourth one divisibility test we are going to learn, that is test of 3. So what is test of 3, or how to identify whether the given number is divisible by 3 without doing actual division? Okay, how to identify, what is the idea? See, what does divisibility test of 3 says? If the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3, then that whole number is divisible by 3. Let's write first and then I'll explain. If the sum of digits of a number is divisible by 3, then the given number is divisible by 3. Okay, see, if the sum of digits of a number is divisible by 3, then the given number is divisible by 3. What is mean by this? Let's take one number of 274,536. Okay, here we have one number. And we have to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. Okay, now what does this test says? If the sum of digits of a number, means what we have to do first? We have to find sum of the digits in these numbers. Okay, digits understood. In this number, which are digits? 2, 7, 4, 5, 3 and 6. So, this number is made up of these digits. So, first of all, we have to find sum of these digits. Okay, so let's find sum of the digits. Now, sum of digits means we need to add these digits. 2 plus 7 plus 4 plus 5 plus 3 plus 6. Okay, so let's find what is the sum. See here, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 and 5, 14, 14 and 4, 18, 18 and 2, 20 and 7, 27. So the sum of the digit is 27. Clear? Till this understood, sum we have found, sum of the digit, we have got 27. Now if a sum of a number is divisible by 3, now this sum we have got 27, we have to divide this by 3. We have to check whether 27 is divisible by 3. Now, divisible means what I have told you. Divisible means what? When we divide 27 by 3, it should be exactly divisible, means we should get remainder 0. Okay? So, let's divide 27 by 3. 27 divided by 3. So, you know that 27 is there in table of 3. 3 nines are 27. Okay? So 7 minus 7 0, 2 minus 2 0. So when we divided 27 by 3, we have got remainder 0. That means what? Sum is divisible by 3. Sum is divisible by 3. As sum of the digit is divisible by 3, so this number 274,536 is divisible by 3. Okay? So this, if you know this trick, or if you know this test of 3, you can immediately identify that this, yes, this number is divisible by 3. You need not to divide this number. Okay. So 2,74,536 is divisible by 3. Sum is divisible by 3, so it is divisible by 3. So what we have to do first, when you will get any number and the question will be like this, check whether the following numbers are divisible by 3 or not. You will be given one number. What you have to do first? Sum of the digits. Find the sum of the digits. So add these digits and find sum. Then take that sum here and divide it by 3, as it is divisibility test of 3. So divide it by 3. Okay, and if that number is divisible by 3, that means if you are getting remainder 0 here, then the given number right here and right, this is divisible by 3. It will be divisible by 3. Okay. We will take one more example. See, this is example one. Another example I'll give you. We have to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. So what we are going to do first? Sum of the digits. Sum of digits. So sum of digits, let's find 9 plus 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4 plus 2. Okay, so what we are getting? 9 plus 3, 12, 12 plus 5, 17, 17 plus 6, 23 plus 4, 27, 27 plus 2, 29. So sum we have got 29. Let's divide this sum by 3. 29 divided by 3. Now see, there is no 29 in table of 3. There is 3 9s are 27, 3 10s are 30. So we will divide here. 3 9s are 27. So when we divided 9 minus 7, 2, okay, and 2 minus 2, 0. So when we divided 29 by 3, we got remainder 2. That means what? The sum of the digit is not divisible by 3. Sum of the digits is not divisible by 3. As sum of the digits, since sum of the digit is not divisible by 3, so this number is not divisible by 3. Okay, so 9,35,000. 642 is not divisible by 3. Understood? Why not divisible by 3? Because the sum of the digits is not divisible by 3. Here sum of the digits was divisible by 3, so this number was divisible by 3. Now here sum of the digit is not divisible by 3, so it is not divisible by 3. Okay? So this is the divisibility test of 3. Write this definition test and then write these two examples. More examples to solve I'll give you later. Okay, now let's move towards the divisibility test of 9. Why I have taken directly test of 9 along with test of 3? Why? Because test of 9 is same like test of 3. Divisibility test of 9 is same like divisibility test of 3. What we have seen in test of 3, if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then that given number is divisible by 3. Similarly here, if the sum of the digits, here also sum of the digits. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. Here test of 9 is there. So if the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, then the given number is then the given number is divisible by 9. Understood? Same steps, same test. Okay, if the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 9, then the given number is divisible by 9. So what, for example, see, if any number is given and the question is check whether the given number is divisible by 9 or not, what we have to do? For example, I'll take 18. See here, 1,87,26,345. This is the number. We have to check whether this number is divisible by 9 or not. What to do? You will divide this number? No, use this test. Okay. So what we have to do first? We have to find sum of the digits. So first we'll find sum of the digits. That is 1 plus 8 plus 7 plus 2 plus 6 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. So let's find what is sum. See, 4 plus 5 9, 9 plus 3 12, 12 plus 6 18, plus 2 20, plus 7 27, 27 plus 8 35 plus 1 36. Okay, so sum of the digits we have got 36. Let's check whether the 36 is divisible by 9 or not. Means this is sum. Okay, so let's check the 36 is divisible by 9 or not. 9 1s are 9 9 2s are 18 9 3s are 27 9 4s are 36. Yes, 36 is there in table of 9. So 6 minus 6 0 3 minus 3 0. When we divided the sum of the digits, that is 36, by 9, we got remainder 0. That means yes, 36 is divisible by 9. Okay, as 36 means sum of the digits is divisible by 9, that means, so 1,87,26,345 is divisible by 9. Understood? If you would have got any other sum which is not divisible by 9, here if you would have got remainder other than 0, 1, 2 or any other, then here you must write the number is not divisible by 9. Okay? Here there is remainder 0, so this number is divisible by 9. So this is the divisibility test of 9 and divisibility test of 3. They are same. Okay, what is the difference? You have come to know. Pause this video and write this in your notebook. Okay. Let's learn the divisibility test of 4 and 8. Okay, so see here, I have taken now the test of 4 and test of 8 together. There is also relation between them, is their divisibility test is quite similar. Okay, so see here, divisibility test of 4. How to identify whether the given number is divisible by 4 or not? Okay, so what does test of 4 says? If the number formed by last two digit of the given number, if the number formed by the last two digits of the given number is divisible by 4, then the whole number is divisible by 4. Let's write first. If the number formed by the last two digits, of a number is divisible by 4, then the whole number is divisible by 4. Then
or then the given number is divisible by 4. Understood? See, you will be given one number. For example, I'll tell you. Let's write one number, 943,784. Here is the one number, and we have to check whether this number is divisible by 4 or not. This number, this given number, is divisible by 4 or not. So how to check? How to check within short time? Using this test. Now what does this test says? Test of 4 says, if the number formed by last two digits of a given number, last two digits means these 8 and 4. So the number formed by, or we can make box to it so that you will get exact number. Number formed by last two digits is divisible by 4. If the number formed by last two digits of a given number is divisible by 4, then the whole number is divisible by 4. So here last two digits are 8 and 4. And the number formed by last two digits is 84, correct? So if this 84 is divisible by 4, when we'll divide 84 by 4 and we'll get remainder 0, then the whole number 943,784 will be divisible by 4. Understood? So see here, the number formed by last two digits. First, what we have to do? You have to make a box to the last two digits of the given number. Number formed by last two digits. Which is that? 84, correct? So let's divide this 84 by 4. Let's divide 84 divided by 4. See here, 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, correct? 8 minus 8 is 0. Let's take 4 down. 4 1s are 4. Yes. We are getting remainder 0. That means what? Yes, 84 is divisible by 4. So as or since the number formed by last two digits is divisible by 4, so this whole number 943,784 is divisible by 4. So 943,784 is divisible by 4. Understood? So this is the divisibility test of 4. If the number formed by last two digit is not divisible by 4, here if you get a remainder other than 0, then you have to write the given number is not divisible by 4. Okay? Now see the table test, divisibility test of 8. It is same like 4. Just little changes there. What is that change? Keep it in mind. See, if the number formed by last, see here. What was divisibility test of 4? The number if the number formed by last two digits. Okay. Now here, if the number formed by last, yes, 8 is, see, 8 is bigger than 4. That means here also there will be little change. If the number formed by last, instead of here there is 2, here it will be 3. If the number formed by last 3 digits of a number, 3 digits of that given number is divisible by 8, here by 8, as it is divisibility test of 8. So if the number formed by last 3 digits of a number is divisible by 8, then the given number is divisible by 8. The given number is divisible by 8. Clear? Understood? If the number formed by last three digits, here see, as we have made box to the last two digits, right? Here, when you have to check whether the given number is divisible by 8, in that example, you have to underline or you have to make box to the last three digits and you have to form that number, okay? So, for example, let's check same. If the number is 5,35,168, this is the number. Now see what we have to do here, as we have to check whether this given number is divisible by 8 or not. Let's check number formed by last 3 digits here we have to find. Number formed by last 3 digits. Number formed by last 3 digits. See, so first what we have to do? Make box to last 3 digits. So which number we have got? 168. It is 168. Let's divide this 168 by 8. Eight twos are 16. 6 minus 6 0 1 minus 1 0. Let's bring 8 down. 8 ones are 8. Yes, the number formed by last 3 digits, that is 168, is divisible by 8, as we have got remainder 0. So 5,35,168 is divisible by 8. Okay, and if the number formed by last 3 digit is not divisible by 8, then you have to write here the given number is not divisible by 8. Okay, so this is the divisibility test of 4 and this is the divisibility test of 8. While studying also, correlate with them. Okay, while studying also, study these two tests together, 3 and 9 together, 2, 5, 10 together. Okay, so these 4 tests we have learned today, test of 3, 9, 4 and 8. Write this in your notebook and with the examples which I am going to give you now, solve as a homework. Understood? If you have any doubt regarding with these 4 tests, you can ask me. In tomorrow's lecture, we will learn remaining tests, that is test of 6, then test of 7 and 11. Okay? So thank you and have a nice day.